And the purpose of Deaf Awareness Month is to kind of bring awareness to deaf culture, to deaf people, to deaf issues. So we have Matt Maxey here from Definitely Dope, and he's going to talk about his experience and hopefully maybe like spark your interest in sign language. If you didn't know, we have a club here, a sign language club. We meet every Wednesday, 7:30 in room 208. So if this interests you at all, come on out and be a part of it. Right? So we're going to start with a little video, let you know a little bit more about Matt before he takes over.
Hi, I'm Chance. I'm going to play a show in Tampa tomorrow night, and I've got all those hard of hearing and deaf in the Tampa area. So come out and see our show.
Sam County through my roots. I was in Turkey for a grand, and Chance was backstage watching. And he's like, what's that? I've never seen an interpretation happen like that before.
You just want to turn up?
And then you look at the deaf community, like, yo, we have like our own rapper. He's moving as a rapper, but he's signing too. Okay, this is it too. My name is Matt Maxey. I'm a video creator, kind of Definitely Dope. Being a hip hop fan is interpreted, but outside of knowing, and the video fan is a comic is interpreted. The mission is to really make sure that this audience who's never really experienced listening to music can see it in a way that they can relate to it with their language, but they can also understand it in its own context without it being blurred or lost in translation. Somebody say, coming up at the club, I think of how he lives in the club, people are just, let's go. So I'm thinking that's how I would define or show what it means to turn up. Because if I find turn up, it doesn't look the same, it doesn't have the same effect compared to if I said, turn up.
Okay, great. science law, all right? So I really hate normally voicing for myself. I prefer to sign, so I feel like it's more expressive when I am able to sign. So when you look at your body language, do you notice that the mood, what I'm trying to express myself, when you compare what I talk, and it's like blah, 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 blah. And I feel like with you all, well, I want you to, when you go to sleep, and when you hear my voice, it may put you to sleep. So I'm gonna find it's more expressive that way. So right now, she's gonna voice for me, because it's gonna show you the difference between the variety of deaf people. So some can voice, and some can't. Some want to voice and talk, and some don't want to. Some enjoy music, and some don't. So right now you're gonna see how we switch back and forth between kind of like my second identity and my starting identity. Thank you.
Okay, so on that note, let me know if I'm too loud or not loud enough or not clear enough or anything. Public speaking is obviously kind of new. Okay. Can you hear me? Alright, so anyway, my name is Matt. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I was born deaf hard of hearing, meaning I have a severely profound hearing loss. My hearing loss is equivalent to trying to hear underwater. You know how when you go swimming and somebody's trying to talk to you above water, you maybe can make out, but you don't know what they're saying. That's how my hearing is without hearing aids. It's just garbled. But with hearing aids, I can hear clearly, I can communicate. But that took a lot of practice. That took a lot of speech therapy. That took a lot of being in classrooms like this, where constantly I have to work 3, 4, 5 times harder just to be able to keep up with the average. Now, after about 18 years, you kind of get used to it. You learn the tricks and trades. You kind of learn how to cut corners, how to kind of read it, how to kind of assume that you know what people are talking about. The more you adjust, the more you realize what you're missing in society. The more you realize, okay, hey, I'm working this hard to try to understand people, but people don't realize how hard I'm working just to be on their level. And people kind of take for granted the ability and luxury that they have in being able to communicate without a second thought. So when I have that experience in life, that kind of led me to this point now with creating Definitely Dope, because what we wanted to do was break barriers. If you notice the hat that I had in the video, it had Definitely Dope kind of graffiti. Underneath the bill, it says breaking barriers. And that's what we used to sell to everybody and give away to high school and college students. So that way, wherever they go, it's a daily reminder to help break barriers any way you can. So my background is long, but we're gonna make it brief. I basically grew up the only deaf kid in my elementary school and middle school. I grew up in Texas, near Austin, called Fort Hood. My dad was military, my mom worked for American Airlines. So my mom, I thank her because we flew everywhere. She would wake me up on a Saturday morning, say, Matt, pack your bag.
No.
We're going to Chicago.
Okay,
I'm gonna pack my bag. And from there, she kind of got me ready to just be ready to go at any given time. Little did I know that later in life, that ability would come in handy, especially after working with Chance the Rapper on his tour, when it was constantly 4 a.m. wake-up calls, 5 a.m. wake-up calls, get on a flight at 7 in the morning, get to the show, get to the venue, be ready to go by 3 p.m., finish the show that night, and take off again to go to the next city. Mind blown. And I feel with me talking, I feel like it's a big difference compared to if I was playing all in that in sign language. Because talking, I feel like it's not the same impact compared to. But you can maybe make out a story. You can kind of see that, you know, there's a round of applause, somebody went to sleep, we got on a plane. You can pick up on things here and there. But the more you see it, the more you recognize it. So that's why I use sort of as an example, just because talking is electric, but we're really talking about it, they're designed for it. I went to college at Gallaudet University. How many of you are familiar with Gallaudet University? In Berkeley, no. You know, that's awesome. You find too? A little bit goes a long way. Thank you for trying. That's a big important part. So, Gallaudet University is the only deaf university in America. It's the only deaf university in America. It's located in Washington, D.C. It's a liberal arts university. When I first went there, I did not know sign language. I grew up talking, had no idea of sign language, even though I had hearing aids and was deaf my whole life. So when I got to Gallaudet, it was kind of a culture shock, rude awakening, because now I'm going into another world where I don't feel like I'm a part of that world either. I never could fit in with the hearing kids all the way because I couldn't hear completely. If you talk under your breath, you mumble, you put your hands up to your lip, I would miss a lot of information. Compared to if I got to the deaf university, then they all knew sign language, and they've been doing sign language their whole life. And here I come, fresh me at 18. Hi, my name, and if you could see how fast they walked away while I was doing my introduction, they were gone before I finished my name. M-A. Okay, that's how you feel? Okay, cool. So what did that leave me at? That left me trying to figure out what's the best way for me to start learning sign language. What I thought of was music. I learned so much music, music became my friend. I love music, I love books. Just because I could understand 100% with lyrics, and I could understand 100% what I'm reading. So with music, it became more of a science. How much of the sign language vocabulary can I apply to the music that I listen to on a daily? Most of you listen to music, right? Yeah. How many of you listen to it maybe 15 hours out of 24 hours? How many of you that never stop listening? That. So with that in mind, that became more of why not let me just double up and try to do as much as I can and apply it as much as I've learned. So for example, we're going to do one of these songs. Yeah, get this. And you tell me how much you can pick up on and understand. Well, you don't really have to tell me, we won't have time. But you tell yourself how much can you pick up on and understand.
Mama's hands, running water, standing still, endless fields of daffodils and chamomile, rice and the black beans, walked in the apple with cracked screens and told prophetic stories of freedom, found warmth in a black queen for when I get cold like that king of doing the dead thing. I speak of wondrous, unfamiliar lessons from childhood, make you remember how to smile good. I'm pre-currency, post-language, anti-label, pro-famous, I'm Broadway Joe Namath, Kanye's best prodigy. He ain't signed me, but he proud of me. I got some ideas that you gotta see. Make a bid with Shorty and they ship it like the Odyssey. They never seen a rapper practice modesty. I never practice, I only perform. I don't even warn, I don't even warn. I won't be reborn. I speak to God in public, I speak to God in public. He keep my rhymes and colors. He think the news is jam. I think we're mutual fans. I used to dance to Michael. I used to dance in high school. I used to pass out music. I still pass out music. The people's champ must be everything the people can't be. I'm getting artsy fartsy, house full of some Hebrew brands. You must have missed the combo. I must be all I can be. Call me Mr. Mufasa. I had to mess the stampedes. I made it through, made it through, made it through. And everything I gave to you, I gave to you, I gave to you. You got it, you got it, you got it. It's coming.
Who I used to kill when we were all here. the dark in my way. It goes on with a lot of things. Say now, say now, say now, baby. So I'm on my own. I was paid for work. It was good friends, but I made it work. So it ain't working, make it work. Tell me, sis, I'm on my way.
Dave Chappelle,
I will never forget the day that we went to meet with Dave Chappelle, and I'm just sitting there, and I'm standing talking, and it just hit me. I'm in the same room with Chance the Rapper, Dave Chappelle, John Mayer, who was Donnell Warden, somebody else, and it's like the year before, I was doing something completely different. So that was a real reality check, real wake-up, just to see how far you can go doing something that you're passionate about. And finally, just being my passion, and getting to a point to where, you know, I'm doing this for a living, and being around all these people that I grew up watching and looking up to, it's mind-blowing. Down to three.
Treat people with respect. Honestly,
lot of times people become dismissive of what your head put up. So if somebody tells you that they can't hear you, or to try to compensate with you, and you don't give them the same time of day that they may give you in trying to understand, that goes a long way. So I found out through life mostly, I try to give people the same energy I want in return. So if I know I have to work above and beyond just to be on their level, no matter what you're talking about, no matter what you're doing, no matter what your goals are, anything, I'm all in. All eyes in my case, but all ears too. And that way, in return, it's the same way. So if it's just, you know, hey, you're not really that, or if I tell you, you're patient enough to kind of work with me or help me to understand instead of just leaving me be like a fish out of sea. Be afraid. That's really the key. Thank you. I am too. Okay. Any more questions? You done? So we're about to teach you now. What do you think of it? I see it. That's all. Sorry. Anytime.
Why are you the only one in your family deaf?
I'm the only one. I'm the only one
that's deaf in my family. I'm the only one that does sign language in my family. My family was always very communicating, so they never let me really feel like I was deaf. It was more the best of the world that made me feel like I was deaf. Mm-hmm.
Be alive, or you want to die. This is die. Right? You like flip over in the grave. That's kind of, if you think about it that way, you just flip it over, right? I want to die, I want to be alive, whichever way it is, okay? Today, you take wise, your hands like this, and you put it down like this, right? That's like now, right now, okay? So you'll just shake it like that, okay? And then tell you why I'm going to like inform you, share that information with you, and why. So I have like something in my brain, I'm going to tell you why, all right? Good? If there's also the part you don't need to die. So this is need, it's like a hook, fire hook in the air. But if you don't need, you just shake your head kind of with it, okay? I don't need, right? All right, you got it? Do you have questions on any of them? No? Oh, finally. Finally, right? Finally, that's the last word that you need. Okay, so these are the parts that you're going to sign, okay, but while the song is playing, the words are going to be up on the screen, okay, yeah, are you ready, maybe, no, maybe by like the last word you'll be ready, yeah, okay, we're going to try though.
I'm not afraid to die.
like the very end of it. Right? So, again, if you think that that was like really cool, we, at our club, we actually learn a lot of songs, or we learn like different words to communicate to each other. We're actually selling like food at the football game next week, and we're practicing signing with that, right? So there's a lot of different things that you can do if you're in a club to practice signing, right?